is proudly presented by Nestle Crunch. Just 2 weeks away, Sunday, November 15th, live on pay-per-view. Nestle Crunch, it's just more fun to munch.
Hello, ladies.
The big Balboski's on the scene, but folks, there is so much surrounding this story. Going back from last week on Raw with Shane, his father, Vince.
Wait a minute, what story do we have here, Kevin? Take a look at this. Terry Runnels. Probably a few more than 10 paces behind Val. Maybe trouble in paradise.
Well, it was a couple of weeks ago on Raw where Terry whispered something into Val's ear that seemed to really bother the big Balboski.
Well, they sure don't look like a couple this week.
The middleweight contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, accompanied by Terry Runnels from Toronto, Canada, weighing 241 pounds, Val Venis.
Well, we sure don't see the usual smiling, cocky Val.
And Terry's not there to help him with his towel. Something is definitely wrong with the Val Venis, Terry Runnels trip.
Let's hear what Val has
Hello,
to say.
Hello, ladies. You know something? We all know that Wisconsin is famous for its cheese.
I knew that.
But we also know that the big Balboski has poked enough holes in this state to make his own Swiss cheese.
That's how they make Swiss cheese, you know.
I heard that.
So Val to take on Bob Holly. But Bruce, we heard just a little while ago the words exchanged between Vince and his son Shane. 28 years of frustration seemed to come out all at once for Shane McMahon.
Well, it seemed like it not only hurt Vince McMahon, but it also appeared that it hurt Shane McMahon somewhat, too.
I mean, was Shane lacking? Was he not getting his father's love all these years? Val starting off very quickly on Bob Holly.
I can't imagine that Mr. McMahon would be the loving father as he is the loving employer that he is.
Well, I know he's a little on the hard side, especially when it comes to Stone Cold Steve Austin.
He's a lot on the hard side, I can tell you that from experience.
Well, I know this situation with Austin. Wait a second. Hook of the leg and Holly kicks out before one. The situation with Austin, though, really seemed to change Mr. McMahon. You wonder, did it change him in his home life, in his personal life, his dealings with his son, his daughter, his wife?
It very well could have, but I believe that some of the things that Shane McMahon said on Monday...
Wait a minute, hook of the leg, Val, three elbows, just gets the one count.
It was a lot more than Stone Cold Steve Austin. You know, his grades were never good enough for Vince. Maybe he didn't go to the right college that Vince wanted him to go to.
And sunset flip, and once again, Bob kicks out at one. But go beyond the words. What did Shane do? He went behind his father's back and signed the biggest star there is to a five-year contract.
Well, let me ask you a question. Isn't that a damn good business move?
It certainly is. But he goes directly against what his father wanted.
But it was a good business move. It was a good business move. Shane's looking out for the company. And maybe it's Shane that's looking out for the welfare of the McMahon family.
Well, what we saw, folks, was a broken... and beaten Mr. McMahon leaving the building last Monday. We know that live this Monday on Raw from the sold-out Compaq Center in Houston, Mr. McMahon is going to make an announcement. Speculation and rumors been flying all week that Mr. McMahon is going to resign. Something to that effect. We're all a part of this, Bruce. Where do we stand?
I don't believe, as I said before, that Mr. McMahon will ever resign. When Mr. McMahon resigns, it's the day that he dies. And I believe that it will be a cold day in hell before we ever see McMahon resign on his own.
Apologies to both Val and Bob Holly for not talking about this match enough. It's a great contest, but certainly this story with Shane, his father Vince, the future of the WWF is what we're talking about here. And where does it all stand? Wait a minute, lateral press, Holly hooks the leg. We're getting word, folks, we've got to take a commercial break. Tape machines will be rolling throughout the break. We'll be right back. Shotgun continues.
Do you smell what The Rock is cooking? He's the people's champion. And when he raises the people's eyebrow, he's about to lay the smack down and catch you with the people's elbow. Now it's your turn to lay the smack down with the people's t-shirt. The Rock's Laying the Smackdown t-shirt. To own yours, call 815-734-1161. Visit the WWF Shop Zone website or send $25 plus shipping and handling to the address on your screen. Know your role. Order now.
Get ready for a billion laughs, a billion surprises, and a fortune in adventure.
So anything I wish for will come true.
It's Richie Rich in an all-new holiday movie the whole family will treasure. David Gallagher is Richie Rich in Richie Rich's Christmas Wish, rated G, premiering this Tuesday only on video.
Here's the 90s way to trim a beard. The 1890s. Today, there's the new Norelco Beard and Mustache Trimmer. With 9 adjustable settings, Norelco gives you the look you want. Norelco. Put it to the test.
Here's what's happening on your home team calendar. There'll be a concert by the Oshkosh Symphony Orchestra featuring works of Mendelssohn and Beethoven on November 14th at 8 p.m. at the Alberta Kimball Auditorium in Oshkosh West. Tickets may be purchased at these locations or by calling the Oshkosh Symphony at 233-7510. Get your tickets for a dinner and dance featuring music performed by Janet Planet and the Big Band Reunion. It all takes place Saturday, November 14th at the Regency Suites in Green Bay. Proceeds benefit individuals in Brown County with mental retardation. For tickets, call 498-2599. When you purchase your holiday poinsettia this year, you can help support the Fox Valley Humane Association, Harbor House, and the Ark of Outagamie County. For order forms, call 731-9831. All orders are due by November 25th. Send announcements a month in advance to your home team calendar at Fox 11.
It's new. Live on stage at Sesame Street Live's 1, 2, 3 Imagine.
Just great.
Great show.
Really fun to watch.
You'll be in the middle of the fun with all your favorite Sesame Street Live stars.
Big Boy.
Big Ernie.
Elmo.
All new songs. All new show. It's Sesame Street Live's all new 1, 2, 3.
Brought to you by WQLH, Schoolhouse, and Fox 11.
Burning with desire. Let's get hot tonight. Call 1-800-440-WILD. I'll do whatever you want. Call 1-800-440-WILD. For a free hot sample, call now.
Bruce, but that doesn't make what Shane said to him appropriate. Oh, wait a second now. We're back on shotgun. Bob Holly has carried the battle of Val Venis throughout the break, and Bruce and I have continued this debate. And I don't think that there's a right or a wrong here, Bruce.
Kevin, here's my point. Mr. McMahon has taken on the United States government. He's faced the federal government and won. He's battled conglomerates like Time Warner and Ted Turner and won. He's still on top.
Look at the leg. Two and no, sir. Val able to get out. Yes, but this is bigger. This is family.
This is family. And this is also a master manipulator like Stone Cold Steve Austin. Maybe Stone Cold Steve Austin. Maybe he manipulated Shane into doing this.
Well, I don't know about that. All I do know is that Shane McMahon is instrumental in bringing Stone Cold Steve Austin back a 5-year contract, which Shane engineered. I think all the fans should thank Shane and should be appreciative. And I think maybe Vince should have done the same thing.
I believe that Vince McMahon has become personal with Stone Cold Steve Austin. And I think that Mr. McMahon was not looking out for the best business.
Well,
when he fired Stone Cold.
Vince called his son Shane incompetent and underachieving. I don't think he can say those words anymore. Val Venis now firing Bob Holly across. Big elbow smash. Follows up with an elbow drop. And the Big Valvoski really putting some momentum together. Of course, Val, I know, would love to have a spot in the Survivor Series Deadly Game Tournament. Folks, more names will be announced live this Sunday on Heat. 6 men so far. Could Val Venis be part of the Elite 16 who will compete for the WWF Championship live November 15th at the Survivor Series on pay-per-view?
Well, the list that we already have in it, very impressive. The Rock, the Big Boss Man, Kane, Undertaker, Mankind, and Ken Shamrock, and we've got 10 more to go.
What about Stone Cold Steve Austin? His new contract gives him one more title opportunity.
Could this be it?
Could very well be. Val Venis now going to the top rope. Looks like it's time for the money shot. But Bob Holly up first on his feet. The great counter move. Reminiscent of the shattered dreams that Val experienced recently, courtesy of Goldust. Holly charges with a hard right hand. And now Holly, he's going to follow Val Venis up to the second rope. Looks like Holly's going to set and deliver a superplex. Wait a minute now. Val with the counter move.
I think what Shane McMahon did was a gutsy move.
It certainly was. Oh! The money shot. It's over. More speculation, folks, about Shane be there for color commentary.
Well, only time will tell if Shane's going to be there. Only time will tell what the announcement will be live this Monday night on Raw. Will McMahon retire? What's going to happen?
The future of the WWF, folks, could change this Monday. What will Mr. McMahon's announcement be? It's Terry Runnels and Val Venis. Still look to be, she looks to be a little apprehensive there. What is Val saying to her?
I believe Val said, I do not believe what you said.
Whatever she whispered to him, things may never be the same.